Unkink Your Think. Today I'm going to talk about my father-in-law Don, who recently passed away at the beginning of 2021. He's getting up there in years. Wasn't related to COVID, but it was time for him to go, and so I want to talk about him and I guess pay a tribute to him and also to parents in general. I first met Don the same day that I met my future wife, Elisa, at a friend's house, day after New Year's Day in 2001. I was invited over for dinner and sat next to my mother-in-law-to-be, sat across the table from Elisa, who I really wanted to sit next to, but somehow it was arranged that I would sit next to Marlene. And this wasn't a matchmaking thing or anything like that. It was actually the children of the family hosting this dinner. I was good friends with them, and one of them asked me if I could take him and his sister to the mall to get away from these old people that their parents had invited over. Those old people were my future mother-in-law and father-in-law. So I won't tell the long story today, maybe some other time, but I went over there for dinner and I walked in the house and saw my future wife, Elisa, in the living room. She was very beautiful. And but back to Don, my father-in-law. So we met then, and they lived in Minnesota. I lived in California at the time. So they were on a short visit. I got to know their daughter, Elisa, better that January, February, March, and called her parents and spoke to Don and asked for his blessing to propose marriage to Elisa in April of that year. And he was always really easy to get along with. I never felt nervous around him. Very funny guy, loved classical music, and talked about his military service. He was in the Navy, a radioman on a ship near Korea after the official armistice, I guess, of the Korean conflict in the late 50s. And he met his wife, Marlene, in San Diego, California after he finished his duty and his service in the Navy. And so they started their family in Southern California, and he was a man of faith. Both of my in-laws were devout churchgoers, but his faith was not something that he boasted about or didn't really make a big deal of it, but he definitely lived it and showed his faith by how he loved his wife and my wife, his daughter, and our kids. And they, I also have brother-in-law, Chris. So, oh, and by the way, the reason I've got this flannel on, my father-in-law, Don, was a great guy. Not really big on dressing up and being fancy or anything like that. Very down-to-earth man, born and raised in Iowa. And he would always wear flannel shirts all the time. Going to church, going to the store, walking around the house, flannel shirt. So at the funeral, my wife and kids and brother-in-law and I all wore flannel in his honor, and he was also dressed in flannel. Don loved watching YouTube videos or shows on TV of the Johann Strauss Orchestra and André Rieu. And he just loved music in general, mostly classical music. jazz as well, like big band. And it was, one of the fond memories I have was just listening to really good music with him. We had a common admiration for Leroy Anderson, who wrote Sleigh Ride, Syncopated Clock, The Typewriter. You might check those out. So it was cool to be able to relate with him in terms of our mutual love for music and also our faith. It's something that we shared. So overall, I would say that the last couple of years, my mother-in-law passed away a couple of years ago. So in the last 2 years of my father-in-law's life, he was alone. And this last year in particular with the coronavirus pandemic, we didn't get to see him as much. But I am grateful that we got to see him on Christmas Day of 2020. And then a couple weeks later, I guess it was maybe a week and a half later, he reposed. Donald's birthday, for anyone who follows the church calendar, Donald's birthday was the day after a feast we call Annunciation, which is commemorating when the angel Gabriel revealed to Mary that she was going to bear a child who would be the savior of the world. So that's called Annunciation. Don was born the day after that. Don died the day after another church feast called Epiphany or Theophany, which commemorates Jesus being baptized in the River Jordan. So I just thought it was an interesting coincidence that Don, in terms of piety and being religious, he was not showy in his religion. He simply lived it faithfully. And he was born the day after the announcement of the incarnation of God who wanted to save us, and reposed the day after we remember Jesus fulfilling the law and commandments by being baptized and echoing John the Baptist's call to repent. And one of the reasons I'm pointing that out is because I'm the kind of guy who looks for patterns or interesting things like that. But the epiphany or theophany part, that word repent actually is related to the title of this YouTube channel, Unkink Your Think. The word repent, and don't worry, I'm not preaching like anyone's going to go to hell or anything like that. I'm not preaching. I'd like to explain the meaning of the word though, because I think it has a general application in everyday life. Some people may hear the word repent and think that repent means, okay, you're walking in one direction and then you change direction and you walk 180 degrees in the other direction, and that's repentance. Maybe. But the Greek word, and Jesus and people at that time spoke Greek, metanoiete, the word metanoia is like bending. And the root word of that word, metanoia, nous, means soul. Metanoia and metanoiete are an invitation to have a different perspective or change your mind, consider a different way of looking at things. And that's what Unkink Your Think is about. It's about, if at first you don't succeed, take a step back and try something different. And so metanoia is an invitation to, if you're doing something and it's not going right or it doesn't feel right, pause. Maybe try something a little different. Maybe consider a different point of view. And I would say that what Jesus and John the Baptist were teaching was to people who are living a self-destructive way of life, take a break and think about what you're doing and maybe change your mind. Maybe have better boundaries. Maybe be willing to say no to some things that you need to say no to. And it doesn't have to be like this super radical change. It might be, but it doesn't have to be. And it doesn't have to be a super huge big deal. But it could be an opportunity for you to get past a mental block or maybe something that you've been stubborn about and finally realize that way of thinking or that way of behaving isn't really that good for you anymore. That's metanoia. And that's the message that goes with that baptism in the River Jordan that we remember Jesus doing on January 6th. And as I mentioned, it was the day after that on which my father-in-law reposed. So those things are going to stick out in my mind. I have to say, he set a really good example to me of patience and love and enduring all things, unconditional love. I think it's very fair to say that Don loved his wife and children and grandchildren unconditionally and without any sort of ulterior motive or manipulation. It just was who he was. And I'm so grateful that through him and my mother-in-law, they had their daughter, my wife, and we have a family. And on Don's last day, I thanked him. I held his hand and I thanked him for my family and for being such a wonderful father. So with that, I guess, you know, maybe pause and think about your parents. People in your life who have been like parents for you, maybe teachers, other trusted adults that have helped you, people that you've looked up to who set a good example for you, people that you admire. And maybe in your heart, just thank them. Or if they're alive, give them a call or write them a card and thank them. It means a lot. And we are blessed to have people in our lives that care about us, that we can look up to. So will you please remember my father-in-law, Don? May his memory be eternal. Don and I also like to drink good beer. So, and this is really good stuff. So thank you for watching. There'll be another episode up soon, but I really wanted to take this time to acknowledge my father-in-law, Don, and I'll also acknowledge my own father, Michael, my mother, Christina, my mother-in-law, Marlene. Thank you, my parents, for life, for everything that you've taught me, for all the patience that you had for me, the love that you showed for me unconditionally. Thank you.
may not. Snooks, I've told you a dozen times you can't go out tonight.
But it's Halloween.
I know it. That's why you're staying home, so you can't get into any trouble.
But all the kids will be out.
Snooks. You heard your mother. The subject is closed.
Can we open it just a tiny little bit?
No. Tonight of all nights, I want to spend a quiet, restful evening.
Why?
Because there's a doctor coming over at 9 o'clock. He's going to examine me for insurance.
Do you think he'll find any?
Very funny.
More chocolate cake, Lancelot?
No, thanks, dear. Not with the doctor coming. At my age, it doesn't pay to stuff myself.
I want some chocolate cake.
Snooks, you've had 3 pieces. Do you really want some more?
Yeah. At my age, it don't make any difference.
Yes, I think I'll go in the other room and lie down. I've had a hard day, and I'd like to relax a little before the doctor gets here.
Go ahead, dear, and I'll clear off the table.
Oh, boy, that couch looks good.
Daddy.
What is it?
If my promise to stay in front of the house,
no.
I saw 3 ships come sailing in on Christmas Day, on Christmas Day. I saw 3 ships come sailing in on Christmas Day in the morning.
On Christmas Day in the morning.
And what was in those ships, all 3, on Christmas Day, on Christmas Day? And what was in those ships, all 3, on Christmas Day in the morning?
On Christmas Day.
The Virgin Mary and Christ were there on Christmas Day, the Virgin Mary and Christ were there on Christmas Day in the morning.
And all the angels shall sing on Christmas Day, on Christmas Day, and all the angels in heaven shall sing. Christmas Day in the morning.
Then let us all rejoice again on Christmas Day, on Christmas Day. Then let us all rejoice again on Christmas Day in the morning. On Christmas Day in the morning.
The sea, while I'm away, oh, please remember me. Someday I'll sail across the seas back to you. It's just a sweet adieu. Cause someday I'll sail across the seas home to you.
Come receive the light from the light that is never overtaken by night, and
let us pray to the Lord our God that we may be found worthy to hear the holy gospel.
Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy.
Wisdom, arise, let us hear the holy gospel. Peace be unto all. From the Gospel according to St. Mark, let us be attentive.
Glory to you, O Lord, glory to you.
And when the Sabbath was past, Mary Magdalene and Mary, the mother of James and Salome, bought spices so that they might go and anoint him. And very early on the first day of the week, they went to the tomb when the sun had risen. And they were saying to one another, "Who will roll away the stone for us from the door of the tomb?" And looking up, they saw the stone was rolled back, and it was very large. And entering the tomb, they saw a young man sitting on the right side, dressed in a white robe, and they were amazed. And he said to them, "Do not be amazed. You seek Jesus of Nazareth, who was crucified. He has risen. He is not here. See the place where they laid him. But go, tell his disciples and Peter that he is going before you to Galilee. There you will see him as he told you." And they went out and fled from the tomb, for trembling and astonishment had come upon them.
And they said nothing to anyone, for they were afraid.
Glory to you, O Lord, glory to you.
Glory to the holy and consubstantial and life-giving and undivided Trinity, always, now, and forever, and to the ages of ages.